Hello YouTube, and welcome to my first ever YouTube video. I'm going to be doing this video on a game called The Hunter, which is available on Steam for PC, if anybody's watching and they don't know anything about it, that's where you can get it. Now it is, if you go to the Steam page, you'll probably notice that it's only got a rating of mixed, meaning it's got mixed reviews. That is not reflective of the game. That is, it's got this rating because it's advertised as free to play, and a lot of people get on there and they basically want to have everything in the game for free, and then they get angry that they can't, and they go on and rant and rave and give it a low score, which I don't think is fair, because it's a fantastic game. Whether you want to invest money into it or not is up to you. You can play it just fine without spending a cent. But if you want to get the most out of the game, then you'll probably end up having to put a little bit of money into it, which I think is fair enough. I mean, it's a really good game. It's been around for about 7 or 8 years or something. It's been constantly updated and expanded in that time. There's a lot of very, very big maps. There's lots of equipment, there's lots of clothing, lots of guns, lots of different types of hunting styles. You can hunt in a blind for waterfowl with a shotgun, or you can hunt with a bow or a crossbow, or even sort of old style muzzle loaders. So it's a very big and very detailed game, and the developers put a lot of time and money into it. And if you're interested in playing this sort of game, which is more or less a hunting simulation, then I think it's fair that you should give a little bit back to the developers, and how much you give is up to you. I don't think it's very fair to get onto Steam and sort of shit all over the game and give it low reviews because you can't get everything for free. So I have spent about $100. That's all I will spend on it. I've got a 3-month membership and a bunch of new equipment and new guns and spotting scopes and binoculars and that sort of stuff. I'll show you a bit of that later on. But that's all I'm going to spend on it, mainly because in about 3 months, when my membership is due, the next version of this game is due out. It's called The Hunter, Call of the Wild. It's a completely new game. There's lots of videos of beta testing on YouTube. It looks pretty fantastic, but this one is pretty fantastic too, so I'm going to keep playing this in the meantime. So like I said, this is my first YouTube video. I hope the sound quality is okay. I don't have an expensive microphone set up like a lot of YouTubers do have, so I hope you can hear me okay. I hope you can understand my accent okay. I'm trying to speak clearly and trying to downplay the accent a little bit. I am from Australia, although I live currently in Sweden, in Stockholm. This is the store where you can buy things. These EM dollars, I don't know what EM stands for, but that's kind of the in-game currency. You pay real money and get EM money, and then you can buy things. So obviously it doesn't cost $1,400 in real money to buy this ultimate bear hunter bundle, whatever's in that. That's the equivalent. I don't know if I can have a look and check it out, actually, just so you know. Okay. So $5 will get you 500 EM. $20, 2,000 EM, and really you don't need to spend much more than that. I mean, if you wanted to spend a little bit of money on this, I'd recommend that you maybe buy this 2,000 EM package and a 3-month membership, which will both together, I think that'll cost you sort of $30 or $40, and with that you'll be able to outfit yourself to hunt anything in the game, and you'll have a license to hunt anything and everywhere. So that would be a sort of good starting amount to spend if you were looking at paying for it. But if you wanted to play it for free, I mean, it is free to play. That's not And they haven't been dishonest about that at all, in my view. It's just not everything is free, you know, and fair enough. So without babbling on too much, I'll get into the game. I'll quickly show you my profile. This is Wombat VVV, that's me. A wombat, in case you don't know, is an Australian animal. It's kind of like a huge teddy bear. And I quite enjoy doing these competitions. I don't do very well in them. I'm not very good at this game. I'm pretty new to it. Although I have been lucky enough to win one competition. I won a trophy for the shooting the biggest rabbits, the biggest European rabbits. That was a lot of fun, and it was quite difficult to get the gold trophy, but I managed to do it, and I'm quite happy with that. I'm quite happy with my trophy there. So. But I have entered into a feral hog shooting competition. This is the starter competition. It goes for another 17 hours. There's 33 players. I'm currently coming 24th. I've shot a couple of hogs, nothing very special though. Nothing like this fellow in the middle who looks pretty impressive with his big tusks. That's part of the way hogs are scored. The bigger the animal is and the bigger the tusks they are, the higher score you'll get. And so we're going to hunt some feral hogs today in outback Australia. And I will show you how to do that, and hopefully you might enjoy it, or you might learn something, or you might think it's total crap. In any case, be sure to leave a comment for me. And let me know what you think. Let me know if it was useful. Let me know if there's anything else I can add. I mean, there is a lot of YouTube videos already made on this game. So I'm entering into that kind of world pretty late. So I'm not expecting many people to watch this. It's really more for me, just to see if I like making these game videos. And you know, if people watch it and get something out of it, that's a bonus. So, Walkabout Creek is the place that we're going to start. This is this area. If you don't know, that's actually the name of the place that Mick Dundee came from in the movie Crocodile Dundee. It's a fictional place, as far as I'm aware. It doesn't really exist. It certainly doesn't exist in this place, which is obviously not Australia. But all the maps in this game are based on some country. This one happens to be based on sort of central Australia. Where you can hunt red kangaroos, rabbits, feral pigs, and that sort of thing. I'll just quickly go over this map, just so you can have a rough idea of what else is offered. This area here is representative of Germany, and you can hunt wild boars and stuff there. It's a really good fun map. This little area is representative of where I live, which is Sweden. And you can hunt moose as well as a lot of other animals there, red fox and things like that. This one is the French Alps instead of the famous Mont Blanc, which is in the French Alps. They've called it Mont Bleu. I hope I pronounced that properly, but if you want to visit Mont Bleu, you can in the French Alps maps there. This entire landmass is, including this little islands down here, is the United States. Up here, I think this is representative of Alaska, and down south is like the south of the United States. It's kind of swampy down there. There's some black bear, white-tailed deer, feral hog, you can see. American black duck, and some other different types of birds, mallard and mallard ducks and so forth. But anyway, we're starting in Walkabout Creek, which is the Australian map. You can start anywhere between 5 o'clock in the morning and 6 o'clock in the afternoon. I do prefer to start in the morning times. The light isn't as good, but there tends to be more animals. I'm not going to start at 5 a.m. It's a little bit too early. The light is just a little bit too dark. It's a little bit too difficult to see then. think I'll make it 7 o'clock. It's probably a pretty good compromise. And yeah, I'm not expecting to win this competition or anything. That's not the point of what I'm doing. It just makes it a little bit more interesting for me if I'm entered in a competition, because you know, you never know. If you happen to get lucky, you could win a trophy, and you could win often. I'll just wait till this music stops before I keep talking. So often with the competitions, you can also win some in-game currency that you can spend on new equipment. It's not very much, but it is available. So here we are at Walkabout Creek. The first thing I want to show you what to do if you're a member. Only members can do this. So if you've bought a membership, you can take a custom avatar picture. And it took me a little while to figure out how to do this, so I'll just quickly go over that. You press F2 on your keyboard, and then you press space. You can see in the bottom right hand corner it says press space to enter profile, photo mode, members only. So I can do that, and I can also, while I'm in this mode, switch what I'm holding. So that's my main hunting rifle. I'll just hold that one and get down on my knees to strike a little pose for the camera. And that will be uploaded now as my new profile photo. So for people who don't know how to do that, that's how you do that. The second thing to do is obviously load your weapons, or your weapon if you're only carrying one. You want them to be ready. If we're surprised by a feral hog, it's no use having an unloaded gun. Now for those that are interested, I'll just quickly show you what I'm using here. I've got two different rifles. They're both very similar in function. They're both used for hunting big game like wild hog and wild boar and big deer species and stuff like that. You need a little bit more punch to shoot these big animals. Some of them are over 200 kilos, so it's no good shooting them with a little gun and just wounding them. I mean, obviously, they're not going to suffer because it's a computer game, but you're still not allowed to do it. They do try and make it somewhat realistic, this game. So the two guns I've got this 7mm Magnum break action rifle. I bought this gun with money that I purchased, basically just because I think it looks cool. And I've got this 0.300 bolt action rifle. I bought this one because it looks very similar to the gun that Steve Ranella uses in his TV show called The Meat Eater. If you haven't seen Meat Eater and you don't know who Steve Ranella is, then I would, if you're interested in hunting, I would recommend you look up that show and watch it. It's very good, but he carries one that looks somewhat similar to this, and I like Steve Ranella's shows, so I bought that gun. They've both got different scopes on them, by the way, so they're both pretty similar in application, but this one's got a long range scope on it, and this one's sort of got a short to long range scope that I can swap over, so I can just swap the guns quickly depending on how far away the animal is. I've also got this 44 pistol. This one is more for self-protection. If you're not familiar with this game, you probably don't know, but some of the animals can attack you in the game. It can be pretty inconvenient if you're in the middle of the hunt. Obviously your character doesn't die or anything like that, but it can really ruin a hunt if you're attacked by a grizzly bear or something. Go figure. The clothing I'm wearing is probably a little bit ridiculous to be wearing in the Australian outback, where it's probably 40 degrees Celsius or over. That's 40, which is very, very hot. But he's wearing Arctic pants and Arctic gloves. The reason I'm wearing these Arctic clothing things is because they offer some scent reduction. You can see here, they offer some scent reduction against all species. And they're the only clothes that I do have that offer any scent reduction. And these wild hogs have got a pretty keen sense of smell, so I like to have a little bit of a little bit of something just to make me a little bit less smelly to the pigs. I've also got a camouflage top. You can see that doesn't have any scent reduction, but it's got a excellent visual reduction against all species in outback areas, and this is an outback area, so it'll just help me not be seen so much. And I've got a cowboy hat. I think it looks a lot like the Australian Akubra hats, and I've got quite a few Akubras in real life. I really like those hats, and this is the closest one to that in the game, so I bought it. It does also give me some advantages. I've got no idea why a hat reduces the sound you make, but apparently it does. The other equipment that I'm carrying is a spotting scope, a pig collar, some binoculars, and in my backpack I've just got some extra ammo, some scent reduction spray, or scent eliminator, I think it's called. I don't know, it just stops you smelling so much so you can get a bit closer to the animals. So we're starting here. You can see the little pink arrow. It's a little bit obscured by the house icon, but that's our starting location. I'm going to stick to this around this area around here. I think I can actually draw on the map a little bit, but sort of around here, because that's where the pigs are in this kind of yellowish area. If I go further out into this red stuff, it's mostly foxes and rabbits and things. The pigs kind of like to hang around these watering holes, so that's where I'm going to focus my hunt today, on the watering holes. So we're going to start here. I'm just going to head off north along the water and see if we can pick up some, see if we can spot some pigs or find some tracks to follow, see if we can hear them. As you can see, it looks very pretty. It looks very, very similar to the Central Australian outback. So this is what it would look like in the arid middle of Australia. It doesn't look like this along the coast. Around Sydney or Brisbane, it wouldn't look like this, but in the middle, sort of around Alice Springs, where Ayers Rock is located, this is kind of what I guess it would look like. I've never actually been there myself, to be honest. And you can see on my hunter mate there, I'm sort of 50, 55 meters away from the starting location. The animals in this game don't actually, they don't actually, they're not actually spawned, meaning they're not placed at the start of the game within a 150 meter radius of that starting location. So there's not going to be anything close to the house here. And it is, you know, it is pretty realistic. There's not animals hiding behind every bush. You have to put some effort into finding them, stalking them, getting a clear shot at them, and sometimes it can take some time. It's not a game for anyone that's impatient, or if you want just a faster action kind of shooting game, like a Quake sort of thing, or whatever that new one's called. I can't remember. But yeah, it's slow and it's pretty realistic, so it does take some time. So I'm walking up north. You can see on the hunter mate, there's a map there. The water is down to my left-hand side. I just want to have a little bit higher location as I'm coming down to the water, just to make the animals easier to spot. usually when you find the animals in this game, you're gonna find their tracks or hear their calls first, and then that sort of guides you into the area where they are. It's pretty rare just to find them just walking through the bush like this. But it happens sometimes, and it's worth checking out the area. When I get a bit closer to this water, I'll start glassing the area using the binoculars and the spotting scope, see if there's any pigs down there swimming in the water or having a drink or splashing about or whatever they like to do. But the pigs do tend to hang out around the border of the water. They do like to be around the water. So it's usually a pretty good place to start a hunt. Instead of sort of, you know, walking off into the bush randomly. So this is the spotting scope. This can be very useful because I can see exactly what I'm looking at. If I have the magnification set on zero, it's got adjustable magnification, so I can sort of identify a spot and then zoom into it. A lot of the other spotting tools, binoculars and stuff in this game, they've got just a set magnification, and when you put them up to your face, you kind of get a little bit lost as to what you're looking at, because suddenly you're looking at the landscape through 7 times magnification, and it can be very hard to see. You sort of lose your position. Can't see any pigs here, but you know, like I said, it's a pretty realistic game. You wouldn't expect to walk out into the bush for 3 minutes and find trophy pigs. See on the little bit of land poking out, there's a little sort of dot just above it. I don't think it's an animal, it's probably a bush or something. But it's, yeah, so you can see from this distance, you can see that little dot right in the reticle there. I thought that could have been a pig or something, but it's just some bushes. I hope the sound quality is all right. I tried making a video before and the sound didn't come out very well, so I've started again. Hopefully I'm not wasting my time. Just to leave a comment if you're having trouble hearing it, and I'll try and fix that up if I make any more videos. Or let me know if you can hear it fine. You probably heard that sounded relatively close. There's a pig in the direction I'm looking. I can't see it with my naked eye, but I'll have a look through the spotting scope and see if I can see in this general area what made that noise. In case you missed it, there's a little circle that comes up on the Hunter Mate that shows you on the map there. It shows you kind of in the rough area where the sound came from. Oh, and there she is. So it looks like just one pig traveling alone. See if I can. Yeah, I mean, between 135 and 165 kilos, it's a pretty big pig, but it's not a big pig as far as this game goes. You really, really want a male over 200 kilos. So I'm not gonna bother shooting this pig. just because the gunshot will scare off anything else that's around, but it is worth spotting them. You spot them by just looking at them long enough until they that sort of white outline appears around them, and then you get the information in the top right corner. Because the more she's got a whole bunch of pigs with her. The more you spot, the more your spotting skill goes up, and the more accurate that information becomes, and the easier it is to see the pigs. These look to me to be all females. That one's slightly bigger. Can't get a spot on the one behind it. There we go. You can see it's got that white outline now. So there's four females. None of them are particularly big. But there is it's a good sign there's pigs in the area. So there you go. God, I wish there was a big male there now, because they're giving me a real easy shot. Often the pigs will sort of trot around, randomly zigzagging through the bush and looking for things to dig up and eat, and it's it can be pretty difficult to get a good shot on them sometimes. But when they're just standing still like that, it would have been ideal. Just want to make sure that there's no male sort of tagging along slowly behind them. Don't know what they're doing there, they're just hanging out in the shade of that tree. I mean, I would get points, of course, for shooting one of these, but it's just, I'm in a competition at the moment, and I don't want to waste time chasing a pig that's not going to score any higher than I already have, and they certainly wouldn't. So I'll leave them to make some more piggies. You probably wouldn't do that in real life, especially in Australia, where wild pigs are introduced pests. They cause a lot of damage to the natural environment. They eat a lot of birds' eggs and stuff like that, so they're really considered pests, and people are encouraged to hunt them and shoot them. Just had another call. It's probably from the same... it's from the same group of pigs that are there behind me there. You can see them trotting around the water, but there's nothing really worth bothering with there, so I'll just leave them for next time. And you can set your character to walk automatically, which is what I've done at the moment, and then you can sort of look around as he's walking, which can be pretty useful. He's just walking straight ahead as I'm just scanning the environment. Just gone back into the locked view now, so he'll follow where he's looking. There's also red kangaroos on this map. There's European rabbits, which are another introduced pest in Australia. And foxes, which are another introduced pest. Just heard some sort of sound from a kangaroo. You can see on the map that little circle pulsating. There's a kangaroo making noise up near the train tracks up there, but I won't bother investigating. Or maybe I'll go up and just see if I can spot him, just to show anyone who's watching the video who might be interested in seeing a kangaroo in the game. Oh, jeez. Just spooked a wild pig that was standing up there. I just saw it a fraction too late. That's a bit annoying. I don't know if you caught a glimpse of him on the right-hand side there. He just sort of bolted off into the bush. Probably long gone. Oh, that can happen. It's a bit annoying when it does, but I should have been creeping along a little more slowly maybe. The kangaroo's probably run off too when the pig did, so I won't bother looking for him anymore. Yeah, this blue mark in the tuft of grass in front of me, these are animal tracks. And that is kangaroo poo. Not really interested in hunting kangaroos at the moment, just because I'm entered into this pig hunting competition, so we'll just ignore these kangaroo tracks. I mean, I won't bother following them. There we go. So it's a male hog. He's you can see on the map there, he's kind of directly where I'm looking. I don't want to scare this one, so I'm going to get down a little bit lower and creep a little bit more slowly. It ensures my character makes less noise in the game. Also, not creating such a big silhouette for the pig to see, because I'm lower down to the ground. I think I can see him walking around up there, just behind this tree. Yeah. That is a very long shot. Lost him anyway, but we'll try and track him down. He hasn't gone far, I'd say he's going down towards the water there. Just going to stay up a little bit higher along this ridge. Will make me a little bit more visible, but the pigs don't have great eyesight. Actually, before I forget, I'm going to apply this scent eliminator. Just to mask my smell, make me a little bit harder for the pig to detect. think I might get up behind this tree here and just put out a hog call, see if I can lure him a little bit out into the open, see if I can locate where he's trotted off to exactly. I can't see him anywhere, maybe you can. He might have just given himself away. No, that's a different one. But they're probably traveling together. So the pigs don't have great eyesight in this game, but they've got a very good sense of smell. And their eyesight is still, you know, still pretty easy to spook. I just saw one moving down towards the water. That is not the boar that we saw before, and that's the one I want to shoot. Just trying to stay a little bit camouflaged in the grass. The male pig went down around here somewhere. Sort of trotted off. I don't want to scare him away. And if I haven't already, I might have already spooked him. Jesus, it's right behind me. Okay, dropped him. That was a very close range shot. As you can see, their eyesight isn't fantastic. I guess he'd crawled down along the, or trotted along the water there without noticing me coming up across the ridge. Oh, my rifle skill's just gone up with this gun, so great. That'll just make the gun sort of wobble less when I'm aiming it. You might have heard just before I took that shot, I took in a deep breath. You do that by pressing the space bar like this. And it just steadies the scope a little bit. And the higher your skill is with the rifle, the steadier that'll become. I'm still only, I think it was level 3 with this gun, so it's not very high. It's pretty difficult, but it doesn't need to be high to shoot them when they're that close. So I shot him, hopefully in the brain there. He went straight down. That's not a shot that I'd usually take. I'd usually be aiming at the heart or lungs, which are just above and slightly behind the front leg there. That'll drop them pretty quickly usually, or instantly. But he was that close and he was facing straight at me, and it wasn't too risky to go for that headshot. So there we go, wild pig. You have to get your hunter mate out to properly identify this kill and see what he scored, and I'll show you how to take a nice trophy photo. So he's about 180 kilo male pig. It's like I said, to win that competition I'd really need something up well over above the 200 kilo range. So this isn't going to win me any competitions, but it's, you know, it's a pretty decent pig. It shows me where I've hit him from. He was 17 meters away. The shot went through his head and into the body and into the right lung. So obviously that's just dropped him straight away. To take a trophy shot, you click on this, and if you press the space bar now, you can kind of drag things around, including yourself and the animal. So I can sort of put myself closer or move the pig into a position that sort of looks cooler, or even get on the other side, and then I can rotate my character around. Then I press spacebar again, I can move the camera around again. That tree is sort of confusing the camera a bit, putting it in a bit of an awkward situation. Okay, so that'll be a pretty decent shot. Now I'll press the spacebar to go back into the camera editing mode, and then I can change my weapon. I think I shot him with that one with the long range scope on it. Would have made more sense to use the other one, but he was so close, he was just about to spot me and either run off or possibly attack me, so I needed to take that shot pretty quickly. Go, that might make a pretty spiffy profile trophy photo. Sorry, that's how you do it. I usually wouldn't bother taking a trophy photo of a boar like this that isn't very high scoring, but I just wanted to show you how it's done. And that's that. The female that was down there is almost certainly run off from the sound of that gunshot. I will call that a video, and hopefully someone liked it, or hopefully someone even watched it. And if you did, leave a comment, let me know what you think. Anything at all, criticism or flaming is also welcome if you feel like that's what you need to do. But I'd rather hear something nice. And that's the Hunter, hunting wild pigs. If people enjoy it, I might make another one. I enjoyed making it, so thank you very much for watching.